Good day, learners. Welcome to mathematics lesson. My name is Nonkululeko Mvuyisa. This lesson is brought to you by Sibono Discovery Center in collaboration with Gauteng Department of Education. In today's lesson, we will be looking at Euclidean geometry. It's a continuation of the work that you did last week on Sunday. Okay, so in today's lesson, at the end of this lesson, you should be able to prove the theorems of geometry of circles, and you should be able to apply the angle subtended by an arc at the center of the circle is double the size of the angle subtended by the same arc at the circle on the same side of the chord as the center. Secondly, you should be able to prove and apply the theorem that says angle subtended by a chord of the circle on the same side of the chord are equal. Also, the opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. The angle subtended by the diameter at the circumference of the circle is 90 degrees, and also an exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is equal to the interior opposite angle. So from last week, you looked at the two theorems, theorem one and its converse. The one that says if you've got a line drawn from the center perpendicular to the chord, let's say maybe the chord is A, M, D. So if you've got a line that is drawn from the center and is perpendicular to the chord, it bisects the chord. So meaning that the length from A to M is going to be the same as the length from M to D. Yeah? And then the converse, which says the line drawn from the center of the circle to the midpoint of the chord, it's perpendicular to this chord. So it means that if A, M is equals to M, D, then automatically that line from center is perpendicular to that chord. Okay, let's go back to the parts of a circle. It's just the revision. I know you've done it. So we've got a radius, which is the line from the center to the circumference of the circle. You've got your sector, you've got your segment. You need to really understand the segment, because with the theorems that I'll be doing today, I'll be talking a lot about the segment, about the arc. Also, you need to understand the tangent, which is the line that touches the circle at one point. I've got the chord, the circumference, and also a diameter. You need to understand what is a diameter. So a diameter, it cuts the circle into two equal halves. Okay? So you need to also need to know the steps to solving the riders. So you need to read the given information and respond or use all keywords. Number two, fill in all the information on the sketch as well as immediately apparent logical deductions. Number three, look carefully at what you are asked to prove. If two angles start at one and try to determine a stepping stone sequence to get to the other one via an indirect route. Okay? So let's look at that theorem. It's still part of the center theorems. It says the angle subtended by an arc at the center of a circle is double the size of the angle subtended by the same arc at the circumference. So when you apply this theorem, you need to use the reason angles at center is equals to two times angle at the circumference. So it says that if I've got this arc, the angle that is subtended by this arc, the one at center is going to be 2 times the angle at the circumference. So if this one is 97, then it means this one is going to be the half of that 97, which is 48.5. So if I have, for instance, let's say this is the center. Excuse me. So if this one is X, then automatically this one, it needs to be 2X. Then the reason you say angles at center is equals to 2 times angle at the circumference. Let me give you another example. If I've got the center, this angle will be 2 times that angle at the circumference. Let's say this is center O. So if this one is 10, this one is going to be 5. Are we together, guys? Okay. Another thing that you need to know with the center theorems, you can't assume that something is a center or maybe a point looks like it's at the center. Ne? They need to tell you in the statement that this is the center. Then that's when you can apply the center theorems. Okay. So let's look at question 10. Which was taken from November 2018. So it says in the diagram, O is the center of the circle. So they need to tell you in the statement that O is the center of the circle. And again, P is a point on the circumference of the circle. Arc AB subtends angle AOB at the center of the circle, and also angle APB at the circumference of the circle as well. Here's what they say. Okay, so I've got the center and I've got the point AP and B. So now they're saying we need to prove the theorem that says this angle is 2 times that angle. So angle AOB, it's equals to 2 times angle APB. So you do need to know how to prove this theorem because you'll find it there in your exam. Okay, let's look at our proof. So under our proof, you first need to write what is it that you are given. So you are given a circle with center O and you are given points A, P, B on your circumference of the circle, right? So under your construction, under our construction, we just join P, O and produce. Let's produce let me just use N. So what are we doing here? Let me show you. So you need to join this line before you can prove this theorem. We join that line and then we produce it to up until N. So we joined the line PO. Then we need to prove that this angle is 2 times that angle. Ne? Okay, so what is it that you are required to prove? Your RTP. We are required to prove that angle AOB is equals to 2 times angle APB, right? Okay, so if you check nicely, you've got a triangle here. Look at this triangle. So if I'm looking at this triangle, I can see that if I say this angle P1 plus this angle A, it's going to give me angle O1 because of exterior angles of a triangle, right? So you say angle O1, it's equals to angle A plus angle P1. You say the reason it's exterior angles of triangle AOP. Okay? And then, but we know that this angle is equal to this angle. Why? Because I've got this line, the line from the center to the circumference of the circle. Remember the radius? So I've got this radius, and also I've got that radius. So this gives me an isosceles triangle. And if you've got an isosceles triangle from the previous grade, we say if this line is equal to this line, then it means automatically these angles, they are going to be equal to each other, right? So it means now you can say, but angle P1, it's equal to angle A, right? Why? Because OA, it's equal to OP. Why? Because those are ready. Ne? Okay? So now we can say, therefore, angle O1, it's equal to 2 times angle P. Right? Because what we did, what we did is that in this equation, A plus P1, where there is A, we substituted this P1 here. Then you'll have P1 plus P1, which is 2P1. Ne? So we have proven that this angle, this angle, it's 2 times angle P1. But we need to prove it on the other triangle as well. Okay? So, similarly, if you apply the same thing in the other triangle, you can say angle O2, it's equals to angle P2 plus angle B, right? So, this angle, it's equals to this angle plus this angle. Again, the reason is still the same, the reason which says an exterior angle of a triangle. But which triangle now? Triangle PBO. Ne? Okay? But, again, angle P2, it's equals to angle B. So this angle, it's equals to this angle. Why? Because I've got this line from center to the circumference of the circle, which is equal to this other line from center to the circumference of the circle. So those are radius. Okay? So you say, why are we saying that? Because OP, let me just write it nicely here. So you say exterior angles of triangle, OPB, ne? And then, but angle P2, it's equals to angle B, right? Why are we saying that? Because OP, it's equals to OB. Why? Because those are radii. And we know that radii, they are equal in a circle, ne? It doesn't matter how many you have. Okay, and then from there you can say angle O2, it's equals to 2 angle P2. Then from there I can make a conclusion and say okay, can I just erase this part? I'm sorry. Okay, so from here we say angle O1 plus angle O2, it's equals to, for O1 we said it's 2P1, right? And then for O2 we said it's angle P2. So you say angle O1 plus angle O2, it equals 2. There is a common factor here, which is 2. So you take out 2 as a common factor, and inside the bracket, you'll be left with P1 plus P2. Then you close the bracket. And then from here, we can just substitute O1, angle O1 plus angle O2, this angle. We said that angle is AOB, right? So it equals to 2 times angle P1 and that angle P2. How can you write it? You say it's APB. So we have proven what they needed us to prove. You need to know this proof. And it's so easy. First things first, you will just prove, you'll just say this plus this, it's equal to this one because of exterior angles of a triangle, right? And then also you say, but this one and this one, those base angles of an isosceles triangle, right? Which we say the reason it's angles opposite equal sides. So in this triangle, you prove that this plus this, you'll get that, exterior angles of a triangle. Then you say, but I've got a radius and a radius. So this angle, it's equal to this angle, right? Okay, and then on the other triangle, you do the same thing. You just say this angle plus this angle, you get that exterior angle, right? But you have the radius and the radius, so it means this angle and this angle, they are equal, right? And then you just equate the two and you get your free 5 marks. Okay, so that method, you can apply it in this diagram when you are given this diagram, or when you are given this diagram. Oh, sorry, when you are given this diagram. What if you are given this one? What if you are given this diagram B? So again, you still do the same thing. You'll construct your this line. You join CO and produce it to N, right? And then you do the same thing. You say angle O1, it's equals to angle. You say angle O1, it's equals to angle A plus angle. Okay. So you do this step, you do this step, you do this step, you do this step. So up until here, you do the same thing. The only difference is going to be here when you are saying O1 plus O2. Now you need to say angle O2 minus angle O1. You need to say this one minus this one, right? And then you say this angle is 2 times this angle. Let's look at example number 1. So in the example, they say O is the center. Calculate the values of X, Y, and Z. Ne? So the minute they tell you that O is the center, you think of your center theorems, which is the line from the center perpendicular to the chord, line from center bisects the chord, and also this one so far. I'm still going to introduce more. So if they say this is the center and you've got the arc, which is AB, then they say find the angle X. What do you do? Obviously, you look at your arc, which is AB. It's going to subtend. It's going to subtend this angle at center. It's going to subtend this angle at center and then subtend that angle at the circumference. So it means if this one is 62 and this one is X, it means X is going to be half, sorry, it's going to be 2 times that angle at the circumference of the circle, right? So you say angle X, it's equals to 2 times angle C. Then your angle X, it's equals to 2 times your 62 degrees. Then your X will be equals to 124. In Euclidean geometry, you can't give a statement without giving a reason. So we say X is equals to 2 times 62. Why? Because of angles at center, it's equals to 2 times angles at the circumference of the circle. So when they mark, they will mark that angle and also mark your reason. Okay, let's look at the second diagram. Let's find the value of y. So here again, I can see, here's my arc. It subtends this angle. So it means this angle, it's equals to 2 times the angle at the circumference of the circle, right? So you'll say angle Y, it's equals to 2 times 23 degrees. Again, you need to give the reason. So you'll say angles at center, it's equals to 2 times angles at the circumference. So it means this one will be y, it's equals to 2 times 23, it's going to be 46 degrees. So in the meantime, I'll give you 2 minutes. Quickly do this one for me, that diagram. So you need to find the angle of Z. I'm giving you exactly 2 minutes. Okay, let's continue. Again, I've got this arc, right? So it's this angle at center, it's going to be 2 times this angle at the circumference, right? So you say angle Z, so you say angle Z, it's equals to 2 times 126 degrees, right? Which is going to be Z, it's equals to 252. Then the reason you say angles at center, it's equals to 2 times angles at the circumference of the circle. Okay? Now let's look at another theorem, but the theorem of cyclic quads. So with cyclic quads, we've got 3 of those that you need to know. So the first one, it says angles subtended by a chord in the same segment of the circle are equal. So the reason that you give when you apply this theorem, you must say angles in the same seg, which is the segment, right? Okay, so if these angles, they are subtended by this arc, you're gonna have something like that. It subtends this angle and also subtends that angle. So this segment subtends this angle and also subtends that angle. So this angle, if it's 38.6, it means this one is also going to be 38.6 degrees as well. Ne? So if I have, so let's say you've got your circle, okay. So if this angle is 10 degrees, for instance, ne? This is A, B, C, D. So if this one is 10 degrees, it means this one is also going to be 10 degrees because it's subtended by the same segment, right? So from here, it subtends that angle, this angle, also subtends that angle. So this angle will be 10 degrees as well, and also subtends that other angle. So it means even this one, it's going to be 10 degrees. So there's a difference between that and also having a center, then having something like this. So with this one, if here I've got 10 degrees, here it's going to be 5 degrees. It's not going to be 10 as well. Why? Because this angle is at the center. So the angle at center is 2 times the angle at the circumference of the circle. So there's a difference between this and also this one. With this one, we have a center and it subtends that angle at the circumference. But with this one, there is no center. So this angle at the circumference of the circle will be equals to this one and also equals to this one. So please don't mix up the two. Ne? Let's move along. Let's look at the second one. Angles subtended by equal chords are equal. And the reason that you give is equal chords, equal angles. Ne? So if this chord is equal to this chord, it means they'll subtend equal angles. So if this angle is 34.2, even this one is going to be 34.2. So if I have something like this again, and also I've got something like that. Let's say this chord is equal to this chord, and here I've got 10 degrees. It means even this one is going to be 10 degrees. The reason that you give, you say equal chords, equal angles, right? So equal chords, they subtend equal angles. Moving along, the cyclic quadrilaterals. The opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. The reason that you give, you say opposite angles of the cyclic quad are equal. Oh, sorry, that's a mistake. Opposite angles of a cyclic quad, they equals to 180 degrees. Remember the meaning of supplementary, it means they add up to 180 degrees, right? So if we say this angle, which is opposite to this one, if you add them together, then you'll get 180 degrees. If you add this one plus this one, you'll get 180 degrees. That's the opposite angles of a cyclic quad. One last one, the exterior angles of a cyclic quad. So if you see a cyclic quad, remember a cyclic quad, they don't have to tell you that something is a cyclic quad, or maybe a a shape is a it's a cyclic quad. You can just see if you've got the corners of your shape on the circumference of the circle, then you can say that's a cyclic quad. Ne? So if your vectors is they're on top of the circumference of the circle and they are four, it's a four-sided shape, then it means it's a cyclic quad. Okay, so with this one, the first one, it says if you say this one plus this one, you get 180. Then the exterior angles, so this angle, which is opposite to this chord, always you must check, it should be opposite to the chord. So you can't say this angle is equal to the angle. That's wrong. This angle, which is opposite to this chord, is equal to that exterior angle. Ne? Okay, so let's look at question 9, whereby we have to prove the theorem. It says, in the diagram, JKLM is a cyclic quad, and the circle has center O. So they're saying JKLM is a cyclic quad, and the circle has got the center O. So you need to prove the theorem, which states that if you add J and the L, you'll get 180 degrees. Okay, so again here, you need to do your construction. How do you do your construction? So if they say prove that this one plus this one, it's 180 degrees, then it means you need to do your construction like this. But if they say prove that this one plus this one, it gives you 180 degrees, then your construction, you do it the other way around. You will construct from J to O and also from O to L. Are we together, guys? Okay? Let's do our proof. So they said we must prove that, what are we required to prove? We are required to prove that J, angle J plus angle L, it's equals to 180 degrees, all right? So if I add this angle and also add with this angle, I'll get 180 degrees. So obviously I said to you, you need to do your construction, right? So we constructed, under your construction, we say you join OK and also join OM, right? Okay, and then from there, we can start with our proofing. We say angle O1, it's equals to 2 times angle J. So we are saying this angle, let me show you. We are saying this angle, it's going to be 2 times that angle, right? So O1, it's equals to 2 times angle J. The reason, it's the reason that I gave you previously, right? You say angles at center, it's equals to 2 times angles at the circumference of the circle, right? And then again, you say angle O2, it's equals to 2 times angle L. So we are saying this angle, it's going to be 2 times this angle, right? Okay, so you say angles at center, it's equals to 2 times angles at the circumference of the circle. Okay, and then, but we know that O1 plus O2, it's going to give you 360 degrees, right? Because of angles at, angles around a point. So you say angle O1 plus angle O2, it gives you 360 degrees. The reason why we say that, it's because of angles at a point, right? Or angles around a point, they sum up to 180 degrees. Okay, but we do know O1. O1 is given as 2 times angle J. So where there is O1, we substitute. We substitute 2 angle J plus where there is O2, we substitute 2 angle L, right? So it's 2 angle L, it's equals to 360 degrees. Ne? Then from here, I can see there's something common. 2 is common. So I take out 2 as a common factor. Inside the bracket, I'll be left with angle J plus angle L, it's equals to 360 degrees, right? So I've got 2 times angle J plus angle L, it's equals to 360 degrees. You divide by 2 and you also divide by 2 so that you can get rid of those 2. So 2 divided by 2, I get a 1. And then angle J plus angle L, it's equals to 360 divided by 2, it gives you 180 degrees. You see? Easy like that, we have proven that what they want us to prove. So with this proof, you get easy marks again. Because you just say, this angle is 2 times this angle. Let me use a different color so you can see nicely. So we say, O2, it's 2 times angle L. And angle O1, it's equals to 2 times angle J. Then we say, but angles around a point, they give you 360 degrees. Then where there is O1 and where there is O2, you just substitute 2J and 2L. You take out your common factor. Then you divide both sides by that 2, which is a common factor. And you get your easy marks just like that. Please make sure before you go into an exam, you know how to prove that theorem. Okay, let's look at some examples. So they're saying here, we must calculate the size of the unknown. But O is the center. So they tell us that O is the center, right? So the minute they tell us that O is the center, we know that we've got the center theorems, right? Okay, so let's start with finding x. Okay, so I can see this is a four-sided shape. It's a four-sided shape, so it means it's a cyclic quad. So this angle plus this angle is going to give me 180 degrees. Do you agree? Okay, so you say angle F plus angle H, it's equals to 180 degrees. Why are you saying that? Because of opposite angles of a cyclic quad, right? So angle F is X plus angle H, it's 83, it's equals 180 degrees. So you say X, it's equals 180 degrees minus your 80 degrees. Why am I minusing 80 degrees? Because the 83, if you transpose it to the other side, it becomes negative, right? Then you'll have X, it's equals to 97 degrees. So it means this one is 97. Let me just double check. So this one is 97 degrees. Then your Y, again, it's still the same thing. So this angle plus that angle, it's going to give you 180 degrees. So you say angle Y, it's equal, sorry, angle Y plus angle Y plus angle E, it's equals 180 degrees. Why? Because of angles at center. That's a cyclic quad. Okay? So you say it's opposite angles of your cyclic quad. So your Y plus angle E, it's given by 105 degrees. It's equals 180 degrees. You say Y, it's equals 180 minus 105, right? So it means your angle Y, it's equals to 75 degrees, right? So we are done with the first diagram. Now let's move to the second diagram. Okay, so in your second diagram, again, it's going to be the same thing. This is a cyclic quad, right? So if it's a cyclic quad, then it means if I add this angle and also this angle, I will get 180 degrees. Also, when I say this angle plus this angle, I'll get 180 degrees. Ne? Let's try to write on the other side. So we say angle X plus 82, it's equals 180 degrees. Why? Because opposite angles of a cyclic quad, right? So angle X is equals to 180 degrees minus 82. So it means X is equals to 98 degrees. Then you get your mark, and you also get your mark. Okay, so it means this one, it's going to be 98. Then let's find our Y, this angle. If you can check nicely in that diagram, you can see that this is a triangle. Can you see this triangle? You've got a triangle. In that triangle, this angle is 40 and this angle is 82, right? So what do? You say the sum of angles in a triangle, they sum up to 180 degrees. So it means if I add this and this and this, I should get 180 degrees. So you say angle A plus angle ABD plus angle ADB, you say it's equals 180 degrees. Why? Because of sum of angles in a triangle. So angle A is 82 degrees plus angle ABD, it's the one that we're looking for, we say it's Y, plus angle ADB, it's 40 degrees, then we say it's equals 180. So you say Y, it's equals 180 minus, so if you say 82 plus 40, you will get 122. So if I take the 122 to the other side, then I'll get 180 minus 122, right? Then your Y, it's equals to 58 degrees. Then also, you'll get your mark and get your mark for the resin, okay? And then we are done with diagram two. I hope you understand. Let's move to diagram three. Okay, so in diagram three, remember they told us in the statement that O is the center, right? So if O is the center, it means the line that cuts the circle into two equal halves and it passes through the center, it means you've got a diameter. Can you see the diameter there? So angles on a diameter, they subtends a 90 degree angle here. This angle is 180 degrees, right? So it means the angle subtended by this line at the center is going to be half that angle at the circumference. So 180 divided by this, this one is going to be 90 degrees. Can you see? Okay. So from there, I can just, let's just put all the information that we need. Let's put all the information that we need. So obviously, because I've got the diameter, I know this angle is going to be 90. So my Y is 90 degrees. And also, if I look at this diagram or this shape, I can see that it's a four-sided shape and the corners or the vertices, they're touching the circumference of the circle. So it means it's a cyclic quad, right? Meaning that this angle, which is opposite to this chord, is going to be to that diameter, it's going to be equal to this one. So it means even this one is equal to 125 degrees. So your x is equal to 125 degrees. Then this one, you say angles on a straight line, then you'll find this small angle. Then from there, you can find this angle by saying the sum of angles in a triangle. In a triangle, can you see that triangle? AECB1. Yeah, so you can also say the sum of angles in a triangle. So just try, before you can attack your question or before you can solve your riders, just make sure that you read your statement, you take the information that is in the statement, you put it in your diagram. So if they say there's a center, you think of your center theorems. If they say there's a cyclic quad, then you think of your cyclic quads. Yeah? So you put everything and you find all the unknowns, or maybe most of the unknowns, so that you don't get stuck when you are looking at your questions. Because sometimes you can go through to the question or go straight to the questions. By the time you go to the question, you realize that this rider is so hard. So before you go to your questions, read the statement, take all the details, you put them in your diagram. Ne? So with this one, we're supposed to find the unknowns, right? So first things first, we set angle D. So we set our x, it's equals 125 degrees. And the reason we set it's because of exterior angles of your cyclic quad, right? Then we have to find our y. We set our y, it's equals to 90 degrees. Why is it equals to 90 degrees? We said it's angles on a semicircle. You can say semicircle, or you can just draw a circle like this and put a dot. It still says semicircle. Then you have to find angle B1. So angle B1, we said it's equals to 180 minus 125. Why? Because of angles on a straight line, right? So it means you'll have 180 minus 125, which is going to be your 55 degrees. And then also, this one, you can say the sum of angles in a triangle. Then you find angle Z. Okay, so let's look at this other example. So they are saying O is the center of the circle. So the minute they say O is the center of the circle, you know, you think of your center theorems. You think of your line from center bisecting the chord. Ne? You think of your angles on a semicircle, it's going to subtend a 90 degree. You think of your angles at center is 2 times the angle at the circumference. So if this one is x, this one is 2x. Those are the theorems that you think of. Ne? So immediately when they say we've got a center, already I can say, but I've got a diameter. So because I have a diameter, I'm looking at this triangle, I can say this whole angle is 90 degrees. Do you agree? Also, I can say I've got a radius, the line from center to the circumference of the circle. The line from center to the circumference. Again, from center to the circumference. So it means this, it's equal to this, and also equals to this. What does that tell me? It means that the base angles, they are going to be equal, right? So it means this angle is equal to this angle. And also this one will be equals to this one. Are we together? I don't see any line from center bisecting the chord, so it's fine. We leave it like that, that one. So we are done. Now we look at our cyclic quads. We are done with the centers. So now we look at our cyclic quad. So if I'm looking at my cyclic quad, I can say, I've got the angles that are subtended by that segment, right? So we say this angle, it's equal to this angle. Again, if I'm looking at this one, then we say this angle will be equal to which angle? To this angle, right? Do we have anything that is like that there? I can see this is the chord. So the chord will subtend that angle and also subtend this angle. So it means this angle will be equal to this angle. And I forgot another angle there. I don't know if you can see it. The angles at center is 2 times the angle at the circumference. Can you see that one? Angle D, it's equals to 2 times O1. Sorry, O1, it's equals to 2 times angle D, right? Also, you can look for opposite angles of a cyclic quad. Opposite angles, if you add them together, they give you 180 degrees, right? And also, you can look at exterior angles of a cyclic quad. But here, I can't look for exterior angles of a cyclic quad since I don't have any line which is produced. If I had a line that was produced, then I was going to look for that theorem, okay? So it means that, okay, now let's just go to the statement. So O is the center of the circle. AB is the diameter. And angle AOC, angle AOC. So this angle is 104. Let me just erase so that it becomes clean. So O1 is 104. And then also angle DAB. Where's DAB? This is DAB. So they are talking about this angle. They're saying this angle is 32 degrees, right? So we need to calculate those other angles. Let's just find these angles first before we can look at the questions. Ne? Okay, so if this angle at center is 104, it means this angle at the circumference is going to be 52, right? Okay, and then if this one is 32, it means this C3 is also going to be 32. Can you see? Because they subtended by the same segment. Ne? So it means they'll subtend this angle and also subtend that other angle. So even this one, it's equals to 32 degrees. And then from there, we can find this one, O2. O2, it's equals to 180 degrees minus 104. Why? Because of angles on a straight line. So this one, it's equals to 76 degrees, right? And then also, if I'm looking at the chord AC, it's going to subtend that angle D and also subtend angle B. So I'll have 52 degrees. And also here, it's equals to that 52 degrees. Ne? And then since we said this radius is equal to this one, then it means the base angles, they are going to be equal as well. Ne? So we can say 180 degrees minus 104. Then you divide it by 2, right? Because they're going to be equal. So it means this one is 38, and this one is also 38, right? And then from there, I can find this one. Remember, we said this one was 90 degrees. So you can say all of these angles, they need to sum up to 90 degrees. So you can say it's 90 degrees minus the 38 minus the 32. So it means this small one, it's equals to 20 degrees. So I have almost all the angles. So now we can try and solve. We can just read the questions and answer. Ne? Let me check. Okay, so the first question, it says we must find angle D. So they're saying we must find angle D. You see, now it's easy because we have angle D already. So you'll say angle D, it's equals to half angle O1. Why? Because of angles at center, it's equals to 2 times angles at the circumference. So angle D, it's equals to half O1, which is 104, and we said D, it's equals to 52 degrees. It's how many marks? Let me see. Okay, there are no marks. It's fine, and then we move to angle C3. Angle C3, it's this one. So angle C3, it's equals to this one. So how did you find this one? We said so we are saying C3, it's equals to this one, right? Because they're subtended by that segment. So we say angle A2, angle C3, it's equals to angle A2. So angle C3, it's equals to 32 degrees. The reason it's angles on the same segment, right? Or just seg. You don't have to write the whole thing. Then you get your 2 marks. So we said this is 52, this is 32, this is 32 as well, and this is 104. Okay? Then we are done with this one. We are done with this one. Then we have to find angle A1. Where's angle A1? This is angle A1. So we need to find angle A1. How do you find angle A1? You'll say angle A1 plus angle C1 plus angle O1, it gives you 180 degrees because of sum of angles in a triangle. So it means angle A1 plus angle C1, it's equals 180 degrees minus 104. So A1 plus C1, it's equals to 76 degrees. Ne? So we are saying if you add this and this, you'll get 76 degrees. Okay? So now we can say, we can divide it by 2. Why are we dividing by 2? Because of angles opposite equal sides. Remember, from here to here, we said it's a radius. From here to here, we said it's a radius. So this angle and this angle, they are equal, right? So it means angle A1, it's equals to angle C1. They are all equals to 36. So they are all equals to 38 degrees, right? So it means angle A1, it's equals to 38 degrees, then you are done. We move to the other question. We are done with A1. We got that it's 38 and it's also 38. So C2, where is C2? So now we have to find angle C2. But before we can find angle C2, we need to find angle C3. Oh, we have angle C3. So you say the whole of angle C, it's equals to 90 degrees, right? And the reason is because of angles on a semicircle, ne? Or angles on a diameter. So angle C is given by C1 plus C2 plus C3. Let me reduce my pen. So angle C1 is 38 plus plus angle C2 is the one that we're looking for, plus angle C3, we got that it's 32 as well. Okay, it's equal to 90 degrees. So angle C2 will be equal to 90 degrees minus 38 degrees minus your 32 degrees, ne? So C2, it's equal to 20 degrees. So this one is just 20 degrees. And we are done solving for that question. So first things first, read your statement, remind yourself of your theorems, and then you take your information, you put it in your diagram, and try to find other angles that you can find before you can go and attack the questions. Because if you're just gonna go straight to the questions, I'm telling you, you'll get stuck. Okay, let's look at this other example. You've got that diagram. They're saying in the figure, O is the center of the circle. So they're saying O is the center of the circle. The minute they say O is the center of the circle, I'm thinking of my center theorems. So it means this line from center, if I'm looking at this chord will subtend this angle at center and also subtend which angle? That angle. So if this one is 39, this one is going to be 2 times 39, right? And also, I'm looking at this chord. By this line, I can tell that this chord are equal. So if they are equal, it means this angle and this angle, they'll be equal as well. Remember, equal chords, equal angles. But let's continue with our statement. They're saying A, B, C, D, and E lie on the circle such that chord AB and chord DC are equal in length, and angle AEB, that's AEB, they're talking about this one, they're saying it's 39 degrees. So obviously, this one, it's going to be 78, right? So if this one is 39, this one is going to be 78, and I've got a chord, I've got a chord, chords that are equal. So we say this angle will also be equal because of equal chords, equal angles. Can we find another angle there? Now let's just go to the questions. Ne? Okay, so now they're saying, determine the size of O1. First question. So you say, angle O1, it's equals to angle, 2 times angle E. So O1, it's equals to 2 times 39 degrees. So O1, it's equals to 78 degrees. Remember, you can't make your statement without giving a reason. So you need to say O1 is equal to 2 times angle E. What is the reason? It's because of angles at center. It's equal to 2 times angles at the circumference of the circle, right? And that's only 2 marks. So you'll get a mark for your answer and you get a mark for your reason. Ne? And then you look at number 2, it says determine the size of O2. We already did that. Can you see? So you say angle O2, it's equals to angle O1. So O2, it's equals to 78 degrees. But why are we saying angle O1, it's equals to angle O2? The reason why we are saying that is because equal chords, equal angles. Ne? That's another 2 marks. So it's a mark and it's also a mark. Euclidean geometry, you just get 3 marks. It's 3 marks. Okay? Let's move to another diagram. Let's look at this example. 9.2, it says in the diagram, S is the center of the circle PQRT. PQRT. Ne? And then PT is a diameter. They're saying PT is a diameter. Okay, so RST angle RST, it's given as X minus 8. And then angle PQR, angle PQR, this angle, they're saying it's given as 2X minus 40. Then they say determine the value of X. Okay, so first things first, they told you that this one is the center. So you know that the angles at center is 2 times the angle at the circumference, right? So this is a straight line. So this one, this whole angle, it's 180 degrees because of angles in a straight line, right? But then if you add with this small angle, then you'd get that 180 degrees plus X minus 8, it equals to 2 times 2X minus 40 degrees, right? Why are we saying that? Because of angles at center, it equals to 2 times angles at the circumference of the circle. So let's solve 180 degrees. Let me just add to the like terms once. Ne? So what is 180 minus 8? It's going to be 172 plus x, right? It equals to 2 times 2x, you get 4x. 2 times negative 40, you get negative 80 degrees. Okay, then let's add our like terms, or let's group our like terms. So let's group everything with X on one side and everything with just degrees to one side. So I'll group X this side. If I take this 4X to this side, I get minus 4X. It equals to negative 80. Then if I take 172 to the other side, I get minus 172. It changes the sign, all right? So positive 1 minus 4, I'll get minus 3x. It equals to, then 172 plus your 80, you'll get 252 degrees. Then you divide by negative 3, you also divide by negative 3. So your X, it's equals to, sorry, the sign here, it's negative. You've got negative 80, negative 172. So if you divide by the negative, you'll get positive. Ne? And then X, it's equals to 84 degrees. So you choose to use this method, or you can also just join TR. If you join TR, then you'll have the opposite angles of a cyclic quad. Can you see? So you'll just work it out and find the value of X. But I find this one to be the easiest. Okay, I made a worksheet for you. So that's question 9. It says in the diagram below, O is the center of the circle. So they tell you that O is the center of the circle. Circle A, E, B, C, D with line BOF, line BOF being parallel to AE or EA. And then F lies on AD, and then angle BOD, it's equals to 100 degrees, and angle D1, it's equals to 20 degrees. The sizes of some of the angles are given in the table below. In each case, supply a valid reason, right? So the minute they tell you that they've got a center, you think of your center DRMs, right? And the minute they say you've got parallel lines, you think of your core interior angles, you think of your corresponding angles, you think of your alternate angles. So you will do it, okay? So A2, it's 50 degrees. You need to give a reason why. O1, it's 80 degrees. You need to give a reason why. F1, it's 80 degrees. You need to give a reason as well. A1, it's equals to 30 degrees. You need to give a reason. Angle B2, it's equals to 30 degrees. And you also need to give a reason. Okay? 10.2, in the figure, QS and PR are diameters. So PR, this PR, and also your QS, they are diameters of the circles with center O. So the minute they tell you that, obviously you know that the angles that are subtended by a diameter, you know what they are. No? And then the angles subtended by a diameter, again, the same thing. And then if they say this is the center, then the angle at center, two times the angle at the circumference. Okay, let's continue with the statement. Such that PQ is parallel to SR. Where is PQ? They're saying PQ is parallel to SR. The minute they say you've got parallel lines, alternate angles, core interior angles, and also your corresponding angles. So they're saying PS is produced to T. This is our PS. They're saying it's produced to T. Is a point on the circle such that Q1 it's equals to Q2. Where is Q1? So they're saying such that this it's equals to this. Okay. SN is drawn. RS intersect QN at M. And angle S1. Where is angle S1? This angle, it's equals to 48 degrees. Then you have to do the rest of the equation. So you need to find Q1, angle R, and angle M1. And then here's another worksheet. You have to find the unknown name, but you are given that O is the center. So you need to find your Y, you need to find your X, you need to find your A, your B, and also in the last diagram, you need to find your X, Y, and your Z. Ne? That was all for today's lesson. Thank you for tuning in. And remember, you can only be perfect in maths if you practice. You can only master the skills of solving your riders in Euclidean geometry if and only if you keep on practicing. Thank you.